and welcome back to Parasitology. For today's topic, we will be discussing Module 12. We are now discussing about the trematodes. So aside from the general introduction to our trematodes, we will also be discussing the Fasciola and the Fasciolopsis. A few reminders before you start watching the video lecture. Number one, please do take down notes. A soft copy of this presentation has been added into your smart kits already. Second is listen attentively, avoid unnecessary distraction, and of course, give extra attention to info marked with a star because it may be a recall question in the board exam. Here are our learning objectives for today. First is to give a brief introduction to our trematodes. And then second one is to discuss the morphology, the life cycle, diagnostic and infective stages, disease associated, modes of transmission, prevention and control, treatment and diagnostic tests of the trematodes, which are the Fasciola and Fasciolopsis. So first, let's discuss the brief introduction regarding our trematodes, or also known as the flukes. Please take note that trematodes, again, are also known as flukes. Here are the general characteristics of our trematodes or flukes. First is, they are leaf-like and they are hermaphroditic, meaning they do not have separate sexes, okay? Just like your cestodes, they are hermaphroditic. In comparison with your nematodes or the roundworms, which are non-hermaphroditic. So, ang ating mga nematodes or roundworms, right, meron silang male at female. Ang ating cestodes at trematodes, or also known as flukes nga, wala pong separate sexes nito, okay? They are hermaphroditic, and yung kanilang general characteristic, yung kanilang itsura, somehow mukha daw leaf or leaf-like. Please take note, all of the trematodes are leaf-like and hermaphroditic except for your blood flukes, which are the schistosomes. I repeat, all of the trematodes or flukes, general characteristics nila are leaf-like and they are hermaphroditic except po sa ating blood flukes or the schistosomes. Okay, next, another general characteristics of our flukes are the eggs of these trematodes are operculated, except na naman kay blood flukes or schistosomes. If you can actually see here in this screen, yan, puro except blood flukes, ang parang black sheep nga talaga ng ating mga trematodes ay flukes. Or ang black sheep ng ating mga trematodes or flukes ay ang ating mga blood flukes po, or yung mga schistosomes. Kumbaga, lahat ng representative na species ng mga trematodes or flukes na yan, all of them has this general characteristics. However, ang black sheep nga at laging may exception ay si blood flukes nga or schistosomes. Okay? So going back again, the eggs of our trematodes are operculated except po sa ating mga blood flukes. Next, when it comes to the infective stages of our trematodes, most of them, ang kanilang infective stage are metasercaria. So dito, hindi kayo masyadong mahihirapan mag-alala ng infective stages because almost all of them nga po, ang kanilang infective stage ay yung tinatawag nating metasercaria. Except na naman sa ating mga blood flukes or schistosomes, which is ang kanilang infective stage ay ang ating sercaria. Okay, we will be discussing the stages of life later on. Next natin, we have when it comes to the mode of transmission, all of the trematodes, ang mode of transmission nila is through the ingestion. However, when it comes to your blood flukes, ang kanilang mode of transmission is through skin penetration. Next, all of the trematodes requires two intermediate hosts. I repeat, all trematodes requires dalawang intermediate host except po sa ating mga blood flukes na isa lang yung kailangan nila. So basically, this has something to do with their life cycle. Diba, ang life cycle natin minsan may mga representative doon na intermediate host. Diba, yung mga pinag-usapan natin before. Here in the trematodes, almost all of them requires dalawang intermediate host nga except po sa mga blood flukes natin, which is one intermediate host only yung kailangan nila for their life cycle. And generally, our trematodes or flukes has two suckers, which is oral and ventral. These are the general characteristics of our trematodes. Please take note, leaf-like or hermaphroditic, eggs are operculated, infective stage, most of them is metasercaria. The mode of transmission is through ingestion. All of them requires two intermediate hosts. Lahat po yan except sa mga blood flux natin. So, hindi kayo masyadong mahihirapan ng memorization dito sa trematodes natin because almost all of them, iisa yung kanilang general characteristics. Ano nga lang doon, meron tayong black sheep or naiiba dito, which is yung schistosomes nga or yung mga blood flux natin. Please take note of those. And typically po, kung medyo nahirapan kayong magkabisado ng life cycle ng ating nematodes at cestodes, ang life cycle po ng ating mga trematodes is almost all of them are the same as well. Okay, so the life cycle of our trematodes or flukes in general, they actually have three main stages of life. First is yung egg stage. Second is the larval stage, which is yung larval stages na yan, may subdivision pa yan ng stages, which is the mesenchymium, sporocyst, radii, circaria, and metacircaria. Pakikabisado po ako ha, nung pagkakasunod-sunod ng larval stages natin. This is very important when it comes to the life cycle of the trematodes. I repeat, the larval stages of our trematodes or flukes, first is the mesenchymium, second sporocyst, third, radii. Fourth is circaria. And fifth one is metacircaria. Then, after the larval stage, na larva now will become an adult. Then, yun yung typical life cycle ng ating mga flukes. So, kung titignan nyo nga dito sa illustration na to. Ayan. So, diba, meron tayong sinabi dito yung egg nga niya, yung adult, tsaka yung mga larva. So, first, the adult stage actually is almost always, of course, in the definitive host of the parasite, which is most of the time a vertebrate. So, yung mga animals or humans, of course, na merong spine, yun yung ibig sabihin ng vertebrate, right? So, yan, pag-aroon ng adults, magpo-produce yan ng eggs. And then, yung eggs na yan will try to enter the first intermediate host, which is most of the time is a snail or a mollusk. Then, inside the mollusk, the egg will develop into a mesenchymium, sporocyst, tas radii. It really depends on the parasite, but commonly, inside the snail, ganun yung nangyayaring development. Nandyan si mesenchymium, sporocyst, radii. And then, after the first intermediate host, which is most of the time a snail, this larval stage will exit the snail into the water to form a circaria. So, nandito na sa tubig ulit, right? So, from the circaria, papasok naman yan ulit ngayon sa ating mga second intermediate host, which is an invertebrate or sometimes a fish. And inside the second intermediate host, it will develop into a metacircaria. And this metacircaria now is the infective stage of our flukes at pwedeng makain ng ating mga definitive host ang ating second intermediate host and then magkakaroon na ng infection dito and then cycle just repeats. That is the main life cycle of almost all of the trematodes. Isa pa po, it is very important that you memorize all of the life cycle of the trematodes because in the board exam, almost most of the time, when it comes to the life cycle questions, kinukuha po nila yan sa trematodes. And I can attest to that during my board exam last March 2019, there was a question ng life cycle, iisa lang. Out of 100 items, isa lang po ang tanong sa amin regarding the life cycle sa buong parasitology. At ang tinanong po sa amin noon is yung circaria. What is the stage of a trematode wherein this is the stage that exits the first intermediate host to the water? Yun po yung tanong sa amin again. What do you call the stage of the trematodes that exits the first intermediate host, yung snail nga, then papunta sa tubig daw? At ang sagot nga po nun ay ang ating circaria. Imagine sobrang daming life cycle ng mga parasites natin. Ito lang ang lumabas sa amin nun sa board exam. At sabi nga daw po nila, nung mga previews na nag-take na, Madalas, ang pagtanungan sa parasitology is regarding life cycle, kinukuha po nila yan sa trematodes. But of course, that can change depending on kung sino yung gagawa ng exam. But still, it is very important nga kung noon lumalabas, eh, of course, pwede rin nila yung ilabas ulit. Kaya po, please master the life cycle of our trematodes. Almost all of them naman, ganyan lang kasimple yung ikot. Lagi lang may first, tsaka second intermediate host, as definitive host, and then ganun lang. We can also classify the trematodes first according to the habitat of the parasite. So, when it comes to the habitat, first is what are those trematodes that is habiting our portal veins? First is we have the schistosoma. Yung tatlong schistosoma, we have the schistosoma japonicum, which is also known as the oriental blood fluke. We also have schistosoma haematobium, which is the vesical blood fluke. And the schistosoma mansoni, which is the Manson's blood fluke. So basically, the schistosomes actually habits our portal vein inside our bodies. Okay? Next naman, when it comes to the lungs, there is a parasite that can actually invade our lungs, which is known as Paragonimus westermanni, or also known as the oriental lung fluke. And there are also trematodes or flukes that habitates our liver and bile passages. First, we have, of course, the Fasciola hepatica, which is otherwise known nga po as the giant or the ship liver fluke. We also have the Clonorchis sinensis, which is otherwise known as the Chinese or oriental liver fluke. And then last one, we have the Opisthorchis felineus, which is the cat liver fluke. So again, these parasites habitates our liver and bile passages. And then another category when it comes to the habitat is those parasites or trematodes that you can found in your intestine. First, we have Fasciolopsis buski, which is otherwise known as the giant intestinal fluke, and the Echinostoma ilocanum, which is the Garrison's fluke. Then also, we can categorize the trematodes according to the types of egg that they produced. So first is those trematodes that produces mature eggs. We have the schistosomes, Clonorchis, Opisthorchis, and heterophytes. While those trematodes that produces an immature egg, we have the Paragonimus, the Fasciola, Fasciolopsis, and Echinostoma. And ito, walang kamatayan na scientific and common names ng ating mga trematodes. Please memorize everything. All of this naman po pag-uusapan natin today, but please do take note that the recall question during my time March 2019 board exam is, which of the following is a liver fluke? Okay, so yun yung tanong lang sa amin, liver fluke lang. At ako kasi nagmamadali ako noon, ang sinagot kasi ni ma'am, Fasciolopsis buski. Ang thinking ko kasi during that time, since nagmamadali ako nun sa exam, mahirap yung parasitology micro nung time ko, ang dapat kasing isasagot ko sa liver fluke, yun lang kasi yung tanong eh, which of the following is a liver fluke? Ang naiisip ko kasi, Fasciola hepatica. Kaso, nung nagmamadali ako, ang naisagot ko is Fasciolopsis buski. Kasi ang basa ko sa Fasciolopsis is Fasciola. But ang question talaga at ang tamang answer during my time based on the choices that was given to me is Clonorchis sinensis, which is the oriental liver fluke. So please take note. Kaya dapat talaga master na master ang ating mga scientific and common names kasi lumalabas nga siya sa board exam. Again, ano nga daw yung minali ni ma'am during the board exam? That is Clonorchis sinensis. Okay, ang sinagot ko instead of Clonorchis sinensis, ang sinagot ko is Fasciolopsis buski. Kasi ang basa ko sa Fasciolopsis, since nagmamadali ako nung exam ko, Fasciola hepatica. So for some reason, sayang, di ba? Kahit 1 point lang yun. 1 point is 1 point. That 1 point can save you from passing or failing the board exam. So please, kailangan kabisado to by heart at yun na nga, yun yung lesson natin is huwag masyado rin nagmamadali kapag nagbabasa ng questions. So for today, we will be discussing the Fasciola, Hepatica, and Gigantica as well as the Fasciolopsis buski. And of course, don't forget what are the intermediate hosts of our trematodes. Please take note that all of the trematodes nga, as mentioned kanina, requires two intermediate hosts except po kay schistosoma, which is isa lang po yung kanyang kailangan. So, paki-take note po ako, may mga recall questions na tayo before. Please take note that the first intermediate host of all of the trematodes, including schistosoma, ay snails po or mollusk. I repeat, what is the first intermediate host of all of the trematodes, including schistosoma, that is snails? Okay, so yan, alam natin lahat yan. Ma'am, okay, lahat ng trematodes po, intermediate host na nauuna, snail or mollusk. What about, ma'am, dun sa second intermediate host? Dito po nagkakaroon ng variation yung ating mga trematodes. When it comes to the second intermediate host, first here we have a fish, which is the second intermediate host of the heterophytes. While the crabs is the second intermediate host of Paragonimus westermanni. Please take note, that was a recall question before again. What is the second intermediate host of Paragonimus westermanni? That is crabs po. Next, second intermediate host of our Fasciola hepatica, Fasciola gigantica, and Fasciolopsis busci, that is our plants or aquatic vegetation. I repeat, what is the second intermediate host of our Fasciola and Fasciolopsis, that is plants or vegetation? Well, the second intermediate host of our Echinostoma ilocanum is also a snail. So basically, ang Echinostoma ilocanum, ang kanyang first at second intermediate host ay parehas snail. Okay? So, paki-memorize po. Kasi kung kabisado nyo po ang first intermediate host at second intermediate host ng ating mga trematodes, mas madali po kayong makakapag-master ng life cycles nila. Kasi 'di ba kanina minention natin na ang kanilang life cycle, almost all of them iisa lang. Nagva-vary lang kung ano yung first at second intermediate host, but definitely their larval stages, yung miracidium, sporosis, radiae sicaria, metasericaria, iisa lang po yan at kung nasaan lang siya, doon lang siya. Yan. So, kung kabisado nyo po itong first at second intermediate host, mas madali po niyong mamamaster ang kanilang mga life cycle. Okay, let's now move on to Fasciola hepatica and Fasciola gigantica. Fasciola hepatica, please take note, that is also known as your ship liver fluke or the temperate liver fluke. I repeat, Fasciola hepatica is also known as the ship liver fluke or the temperate liver fluke. Hepa nga, di ba? Ang hepa, something to do with your liver. So basically, this Fasciola hepatica is of course, natatagpuan yan sa liver or possibly matagpuan sa liver. And when it comes to Fasciola gigantica, it's also known as the giant liver fluke or the tropical liver fluke. Please take note of their common names. Disease associated for the Fasciola, we have the ship liver rot or otherwise known as fasciolysis. When it comes to the infective stage, di ba nga po lahat ng trematodes ang kanilang infective stage ay metasericaria, except kay schistosomes or blood fluke. Diagnostic stage of Fasciola is eggs and stool or yung direct fecal smear nga. Makakita po kayo ng eggs sa mga pupo natin. And of course, when it comes to the intermediate host, again, first intermediate host, lahat po ng trematodes, including the schistosoma, the first intermediate host is a snail. While the second intermediate host of our Fasciola hepatica and gigantica are aquatic vegetation. Please take note that the Fasciola hepatica gigantica, best specimen of choice to diagnose this specific parasite is your liver aspirate, since both of these parasites actually inhabits our liver. That's why ang kanyang best specimen of choice to diagnose Fasciola is, of course, liver aspirate. When it comes to the morphology of our Fasciola, please take note of this. When it comes to the morphology of the eggs of our Fasciola gigantica and hepatica, the eggs are large. Then they are ovoid, so parang paoblong. They are operculated, so basically may operculum. Ayan, may parang takip. Yun yung operculum eh. They are yellowish-brown in color with a well-rounded posterior end, and it is characteristically hen egg shape. Diba mukha siyang itlog ng manok, yung shape niya. But guys, please take note that the Fasciola gigantica ova is larger in comparison with the Fasciola hepatica, but the morphology po is almost the same. Mas malaki lang po ang Fasciola gigantica natin when it comes to the morphology. And when it comes to Fasciola na ating mga adults, this is the adult Fasciola hepatica. Please take note that there is a presence of the cephalic cone. Ayan. They have two shoulders, converging margins, and they are smaller in size in comparison with your Fasciola gigantica, wherein there is a less prominent shoulder. Ito yung shoulder niya, di ba? Compared nyo dito, ito yung shoulder ng Fasciola hepatica. Ayan, di ba? Broad yung kanyang shoulder. Dito kayo Fasciola gigantica, parang nakababa yung shoulder. Imagine niyo kung yung tao, di ba? They have less prominent shoulders and parallel margins siya instead of converging. Plus, of course, since in its term, gigantica, giant, they are larger in size in comparison with your Fasciola hepatica. Again, what is the characteristic morphology of the adults Fasciola hepatica and gigantica? Again, Fasciola hepatica has the presence of a cephalic cone. Ayan, di ba? May cone siya sa taas. It has two shoulders, broad shoulders ang ating hepatica. They have a converging margin as well as it is smaller in size in comparison with your Fasciola gigantica. While the Fasciola gigantica po, larger in size and it has less prominent shoulders and it has parallel margins. Okay, so ito yung life cycle ha. Dapat master nyo po itong mga life cycle ng ating mga trematodes. First, here we have an unembryonated egg that should be passed in the feces of those infected. So, this unembryonated egg will enter the water wherein it will become embryonated. And then, once in the water, it will develop into a miracidia. And this miracidia now will seek out a snail intermediate host or yung first intermediate host nga po natin. This miracidia now in the water will enter or penetrate our first intermediate host, which is our snails. And inside the snail, from the miracidia, it will develop inside the snail into a sporocyst, papunta sa radii, papunta sa cercaria. This cercaria now inside the snail will penetrate the snail again, papunta sa tubig ulit. And then the free-swimming cercariae can insist in the aquatic vegetation, which is the second intermediate host. And then, once here in the aquatic vegetations or the second intermediate host, the cercaria will develop into a metacercaria, which is the infective stage of our Fasciola. Metacercaria now on the second intermediate host, which is the aquatic vegetation, can be ingested by our definitive host. And then once inside the intermediate host or the definitive host, it can become an adult and then the cycle will repeat. So again, ulitin natin, what is the life cycle of our Fasciola? Again, first, an embryonated egg can be passed in the feces, papunta sa tubig. And then once this unembryonated egg reaches the bodies of water, it will be embryonated. From the embryonated egg, it will hatch, forming a miracidia. This miracidia now can penetrate our first intermediate host, which is the snail. And then once inside the snail, it will develop into a sporocyst, to a radii, papunta sa cercariae. This cercariae now will exit our first intermediate host, papunta ulit sa bodies of water. And then the free-swimming cercariae will insist on the second intermediate host, which is your aquatic vegetation. Once in the aquatic vegetation, the cercariae now will develop into a metacercaria, which is the infective stage of our Fasciola. And then this metacercaria that can be found in the second intermediate host, which is the aquatic vegetation, can be ingested by the definitive host. And then once inside the definitive host, this metacercaria can develop into adults and then the cycle repeats. That is the life cycle of our fasciola. When it comes to the laboratory diagnosis of Fasciola hepatica and gigantica, the diagnosis is based on the recovery of the eggs in the patient's stool using direct fecal smear. Fasciola eggs may be present in stool of individual who has earlier consumed infected animal liver, so please do not eat liver po, animal liver na undercooked, because it can cause false fasciolysis. And please take note, you can also check for fasciola infection using serological interventions such as immunodiagnostic tests, mga assays, screening tests, mga antigen testing in the serum. So, pwede din po yun. But then again, please take note that the best specimen of choice for fasciola hepatica and gigantica is the liver aspirate, since you can actually find this parasite in the liver. So, yun yung best specimen. When it comes to the treatment, prevention, and control, treatment po is bifenthiol is the drug of choice. And when it comes to the prevention of this parasite, of course, thorough washing and cooking of vegetables and boiling drinking water in areas where infection is endemic is advisable. And of course, elimination of the first intermediate host, which is the snail nga, and killing the parasite present in the reserva host by chemotherapy is another intervention and control process. So, yun kasi, ang pinakamahalaga kasi sa mga parasite na to talaga, kung saan nyo siya nakukuha, dun nyo siya i-eliminate. At since nga ang nakukuha ang Fasciola hepatica at gigantica dun sa ingestion ng aquatic vegetation that can contain the metasercaria, so dapat ilinisin muna natin yung mga vegetables, tsaka of course yung tubig kung saan natin siya pwede matagpuan. Okay, next natin, another species of the trematode, we have the Fasciolopsis busci. Fasciolopsis busci, please take note. Huwag niyong gagawin yung pagkakalmali ni ma'am nung board exam. Ang Fasciolopsis busci po is otherwise known as the giant intestinal fluke. I repeat, Fasciolopsis busci is the giant intestinal fluke po. Sa intestines po, natatagpuan ng Fasciolopsis busci, ha? Hindi po sa liver. Yan, huwag niyong gagawin yung pagkakamali ni ma'am. Again, ang Fasciolopsis busci po ay giant intestinal fluke. Mode of transmission, of course, is through ingestion po. While the infective stage, just like almost all of the trematodes, is a metasercaria, while the diagnostic stage is also eggs in stool. Please take note that the intermediate host nga, ang first intermediate host is of course a snail, just like all of the trematodes. While the second intermediate host, just the same with the fasciola, ang kanyang second intermediate host po is aquatic vegetation as well. When it comes to the morphology of our fasciolopsis, the eggs po has a yellowish ellipsoidal egg measuring 80 to 85 microns. It is thin-shelled and it is rounded at both ends and it is operculated. Please take note, no, ang isa sa major differences ng fasciola at fasciolopsis. Ayan. Si fasciolopsis kasi, ganyan yung kanyang shape, tapos kitang-kita yung operculation niya. Well, the fasciolopsis nga, both ends po nito are operculated, okay? So, dito sa side na to, tsaka dito sa pangalawang side, both ends niya ay merong takip nga. So, both ends are operculated. That is the characteristic morphology of our fasciolopsis egg po. While the adults naman, the fasciolopsis busci adults, it is a large trematode parasitizing man measuring 20 to 70 millimeters in length. So, malaki yan, no? Hindi yan microns. Millimeter yan. It is elongated and it is oval in shape. Yan, mahaba daw. The oral sucker is about 1/4 of the size of the nearby ventral sucker. This fluke resembles Fasciola hepatica. Please take note of that. However, it does not have any cephalic cone. And shoulder and the intestinal ceca are simple but wavy and unbranched. That is the adult morphology of our Fasciolopsis busci. Isa talaga sa major difference ng fasciola at fasciolopsis is yung Fasciolopsis busci natin, wala siya nung tinatawag na cephalic cone. So, di ba ito si cephalic cone, no? Ayan, o. No? Ayan ang cephalic cone ng fasciola. At kung i-compare niyan sa ating Fasciolopsis, wala po siyang ganun. Okay? And this is the life cycle of our Fasciolopsis busci. So Fasciolopsis busci starts with unembryonated egg in the feces as well. Then this unembryonated egg can reach the bodies of water wherein it will be embryonated. And then once embryonated in the water, it will hatch into a miracidia. This miracidia now can penetrate the snails. And then inside the snail, di ba ganun din, it will develop into a sporosis, radii, sarcaria. And then this sarcaria now will exit the snail. It will become a free-swimming sarcaria in the bodies of water. And then the free-swimming sarcaria will go to the aquatic vegetation, which is the second intermediate host. And then in the second intermediate host, it will develop into a metasarcaria, which is the infective stage on the water plant. This can be ingested by our definitive hosts, which are either the humans or pigs, causing an infection. And then, man, pag nakain mo yung metasarcaria, magde-develop yan into an adult in our small intestine, and then the cycle just repeats. O, diba, almost the same lang sila ng life cycle ng ating fasciola. Tatandaan nyo kasi talaga kung nasaan nangyayari yung first intermediate host at second intermediate host. But almost all of them, almost all trematodes, ganito po ang kanilang life cycle. Nagvavary lang talaga doon sa first at second intermediate host. Okay, when it comes to the laboratory diagnosis is made by demonstration of eggs in stool for the Fasciolopsis busci, wherein yung characteristic, both ends nga have operculum, yun yung kanyang morphologic characteristic. When it comes to the treatment, praziquantel, niclosamide, tetrachloroethylene, hexylresorcinol, and diclorophen have been used to treat fasciolopsis. And then, prevention and control po. Pollution of swamps or ponds where aquatic plants are cultivated should be stopped. Since nakukuha nga po ang ating fasciolopsis through the ingestion of the metasarcaria that can be found on the second intermediate host, which is the aquatic plants. And washing and boiling of plants is necessary kasi nga doon po makukuha yung metasarcaria. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions or clarifications, you may message me through this email.